What's up, guys? Rudolph here, and today we're going to be doing the top three craziest poker bluffs. These are hand-selected that I thought made the cut for the craziest bluffs, and we're going to kick it off here with number three. Let's jump into the action.
Day two with over 160,000. A7 off for Ian Munns, an amateur from England.
He's on the button.
And a re-raise from the button to 9,000.
King deuce against A7. It's kamikaze poker, Lon. You don't need a hand. All you need is the will to put your chips in the middle.
A re-raise now back to Blom. And he'll make the call for 6,000 more.
This hand starts off with some street poker. King deuce suited is a pretty liberal open out of the hijack. A7's a pretty liberal three bet on the button. And king deuce suited taking a flop, it's loose too. I guess let's just play some poker, guys. Let's play some poker.
The flop is ace-ace. Trey Munns hits the jackpot with trips. Blum comes up empty and checks. Munns bets 9,000.
I thought Munns might check there and hope that Blum bluffs at it on the turn.
No, but he'll bluff at it here. A check raise bluff to 58,000.
58K? This is madness. He has nothing except a backdoor flush draw. All right, well, now I guess Munns has to call and play some turns.
Blom, you said, is 18?
Yeah.
I'm not sure he's going to make it to 19.
Not with plays like that.
It's starting to look like he's going to three bet the flop. I guess that's that.
And now Munns with a re-raise of his own to 116,000.
Munns rebuffs Blom's bluff.
Blom goes all in.
It's a brave new world out there, Lon.
Not only did he bluff jam for his entire life, let's run that back. How many seconds that I got? I'm going to time this on my phone. How long do we got? Ready? All right. 116 in the tank. Going to make a move. All in 9 seconds. He not only rejammed, it took him 9 seconds to come in over the top. This is nuts.
Blom with squad douche. But look at the pressure he's put on the 96% hand. And now it has to run through Munns' head. If Blum's got a better ace, he'd be all but dead.
If I'm Munns here and I'm now facing this action, you've got to be at least a little bit afraid that your opponent has a hand that has you beat. That said, you shouldn't be three-betting the flop planning on folding. And also, because there's a flush draw out there, it's kind of easy just to put him on clubs. I mean, maybe he would check raise the flop so he doesn't have to fold the turn or in awkward turn spots. And he's just going to play for all of it on the flop with the added bonus if your opponent has a hand like kings, queens, or jacks. You can get him to fold. So it kind of looks like a flush draw possibly, but can this bluff get through?
If he's got pocket threes, Munns would be all but dead.
Wow.
Okay, cool.
He does call.
Okay, cool.
And shows the ace. Oh, and Blum sees he's in huge trouble.
Well, I wouldn't even have turned over the king deuce. I would have just put the cards in my pocket and run toward Piccadilly Circus.
And that 10 on the turn means Blum is drawing dead after a bluff gone very bad, and he looks for the nearest exit.
Well, that's the poker equivalent of running down Main Street pantsless.
This hand is a hand played between Tom Dwan and Sammy George from a dirt challenge that actually got finished. Let's roll the clip.
Tom opens to 6,000 here, double the raise he's been making from the button previously, with 7 deuce.
Oh, also, there is a bounty on winning a hand with 7 deuce off.
Just take it back.
You don't have deuce.
Tom announces his hand, and Sammy doesn't believe him.
I generally try to avoid strategy-dense information here on this channel, but here it feels like it's due. At the start of the hand, don't tell your opponent your hand.
Either 7 deuce or a very strong hand trying to look like 7 deuce, I think.
Bet 1,000.
How much?
He's bet nearly the size of the pot, and Sammy calls here. Tom should pretty much be done with this at this stage, right? I mean...
Well, it's hard to say.
Raise.
Oh. I like the decision from Durr to bet the flop, but I'm not a big fan of Sammy's raise. If you get too much action on this board, especially when you're this deep, you're not going to be happy about the situation. Also, there are lots of bad turns and rivers. If the board pair is not giving you a boat, it's bad. If another heart comes, it's bad. And also, if the board just bricks out by the river, you're kind of lost in what you should do. We should see a call here, but instead, we do see a raise. And we know Tom Dwan's feeling a little frisky here with the 7 deuce.
You know, the heart will come, and Tom could be in big trouble.
Behind. I wonder if he's reading something into that raise size by Sammy. It reminds me a little bit of the queen-jack hand, where Sammy had queen-jack and Tom had 7-5 on queen-6-3, and Sammy made a little check raise, and then Tom ended up bluffing him out of the pot. I wonder if something similar might be going on here, if Tom thinks Sammy has made that check raise with a medium-strength hand that he might not be willing to get all his chips in with.
That's a big bet.
It is.
4K, 1,000?
That's... 4K. That's a crazy bet. I mean, like, Dirk could... He must think he's drawing dead right now, Dirk.
He probably thinks he's got a shot at the heart being live, but a whole lot of the time, yeah, he'll be drawing dead to a small or medium flush or something like top or second pair with a big heart.
Time to give up.
He's come this far. It's got to be tempting to try to win that 162,000 in the middle one way or another.
I mean, surely Sammy's checked the call here and Durr knows it.
Sammy has a stronger hand than I think Tom would expect.
Thinking maybe he's got something like just a dry king of hearts and they can take him off it.
Or something like king jack with the king of hearts, king 10 with the king of hearts for a gut shot.
He sure looks like he's gonna fire here. What do you guys think? 70, 80K?
Come on.
No.
Wow! That is a gigantic bet.
No way.
More than double the pot. What is Sammy gonna do here? This making things awfully tough on him.
You know, he's checked there. He's checked there to call instantly, hasn't he? And now
that was the plan, but that plan goes out the window when your opponent bets over double the pot. Looks like Sammy might be getting ready to get rid of those cards.
Wow.
Fold, Sammy. There it goes. And Tom will table the 7-2 to collect an additional 10,000.
Tom says, sorry, but I have to show. Not buying it there, buddy. We know what you were thinking. And now on to our number one hand.
And a 3-1 chip, please.
Wait. I'm sorry. Can we play the start of that video again? Why is it so goddamn windy? Are we outside right now?
What poker he's playing in this heads-up battle?
One cool customer, too. Great poker face. Let's go to the table. It's going to be on him. This time, got a 7-5 offsuit.
Well, that's very obvious.
Call.
He hasn't seen a hand he didn't like in this heads-up battle. He limps in and calls here with a 7-high. And
Isaac right behind him with a 3-deuce of diamonds. No, he's not going to raise. So finally...
So the hand begins with Ryan limping in with 7-5 and Ike deciding to check in the big one with 3-2 suited. They both could have played their hands a little more aggressive, but this line is also acceptable.
Well, flop comes ace, queen 4 with 2 hearts. Isaac with the wheel draw.
Yeah, he's checked it. And now Ryan, who hit nothing there, is getting chips out, betting on position.
And he's going to bet 300,000 here.
Call.
And he's quickly called with a straight draw by Isaac.
The flop comes ace, queen 4, and Ike checks with his gut shot to the nuts. Over to Ryan, he likes to bet with his 7-5, and I like this play. You get your opponent to fold, it's a win when you have 7 high. And additionally, you could turn some draws on a 3 or a 6 where you can barrel, having picked up equity, to a straight. Ike now elects to call, which seems like the right play. You could maybe argue for a check raise to put your opponent in a tough spot with no showdown and some equity. But overall, I think the call looks good.
Ryan, not particularly liking that.
Well, king of diamonds comes off now.
Helps neither player.
Isaac is checked.
Will Ryan fire once again with his nothing hand? No, slows down.
Okay, everyone bricks. Check, check. This looks pretty standard to me.
So off to the river we go. Well, the queen of clubs comes off. As the cards lie, Ryan's got the best hand with the 7-high.
700,000.
And he bets 700,000.
Well, Vince, the only way Isaac can win this pot is to bet at it. He's got the worst 2 cards you could have right now, a deuce and a 3, and he's taking a stab at it for 700,000.
The river is an offsuit queen, and the board bricks out for both players. Now Ike has a pretty clear bluff. He can represent an ace, he can represent a queen, he may represent jack 10 as well. and he has three highs, so this is a pretty good spot to turn up the heat.
Raise.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. Ryan, with almost as bad a hand, says raise.
Well, this is incredible. Vince, he thinks he's stealing the pot. Ironically, he's got the best hand with the seven high here.
Okay, so don't try this at home, kids, but now Ryan is trying to represent either Jack 10 or a slow-played big hand, or maybe even a good queen that weirdly bet the flop and then decided to check, turn, and raise river. Not many credible holdings, and if you start doing this too much, you're going to be bluffing way too often. That said, it's a pretty boss play with seven high, and now Ike really has no choice but to let his hand go. You know, what can you do with three high when you're facing this raise? It's already a ridiculous spot to begin with. You got to be done with the hand.
But he doesn't know it. And look at this. He is raising it, going to make it $2 million. With absolute Garfunkel.
What an amazing raise this is.
Man, he's raised it $1.3 million. And right now, Isaac has a migraine headache. Oh. Ryan Doubt, you know, it's like Isaac's cards are turned face up on the board. The way Ryan's playing him, Vince, incredible.
And Isaac sickened.
Well, he puts his head down like he's sick to his stomach, and I don't blame him. He took a stab at this pot, and the guy raised him to $2 million, and he has absolutely nothing.
But he hasn't mucked yet. I mean, the only ridiculous chance he would have to do something like go over the top, please don't start that.
He's got the worst two cards you could have at this moment.
Ryan now saying, what's going on? Why is he taking so long?
Re-raise, all in.
What the fuck is going on? This hand is getting insane at this point. I mean, what is Ike even representing? Jack 10? Maybe a strong queen? But with those hands, you might have to even wonder if your opponent has you beat. I mean, he's kind of saying he has a strong queen, a straight, or a boat. If I have a queen, I'm just going to call here on the river. I have no idea what Ike's thinking. You know what? Back to the hand.
He's going to go all in.
Wow, Vince, he's done it. He's pulled the trigger for all his chips. And there's no way Ryan can call him. Ryan was bluffing himself with a seven high.
And look at this. Isaac's going to show the hand. Oh, he's going to put some salt in the wound.
Wow. Isaac Haxton bluffed him completely, Vince. He moved all in with a deuce three, the worst two cards you could be holding in that spot. What a play by Isaac Haxton there.
You're gonna like when that's on TV.
Have you heard? Herbal Essences Smooth and Shine collections are back and more irresistible than ever. Yeah! It's an experience everyone will be asking for.
Thank you for joining me for three of the craziest pots I could find. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.